Hi, my name's Amanda Frampton, and I'm an education success manager with Microsoft ANZ, and I'm an ex-educator. And today I'm going to be showing you how you can use Copilot commercial data protection to personalize learning for a reading activity with your class. Now, there are so many ways that you can use generative AI to personalize learning, but I'm going to showcase this activity and give you a sneak peek at one of our learning accelerators called Reading Progress. So I'm just going to head out to my browser, and I am teaching a unit on endangered species. And so I want to create some specific content for my students to read about some of the species that we are analyzing. Now, this is one of my favorite websites. You may not have heard of the Pacific Northwest Tree Octopus. If you haven't, that's okay, because this is a fake website that has been created for students to analyze information from the internet. But I'm going to use it for this example because it's fun. So I'm going to head over here in my Edge browser to my built-in Copilot in the sidebar. And when I open it up, I'm going to see my green shield up the top here because I'm signed in, and that means I have commercial data protection. So when I shared organizational data down here in my prompt, it doesn't go to train the large language model. Now for year six, this website is probably a little bit involved. So I wanted to create a reading passage that is a little bit more suited to their reading levels. So what I'd like to do is create an exemplar information report that they can read, understand the structure of an information report, and then answer some comprehension questions about. So using the web page, I am going to prompt generative AI to create that for me. Here's a prompt that I prepared earlier, and I'm going to ask it to include some cohesive devices in the text so students can get an understanding of what that means to put those into their writing. So I execute my prompt or submit my prompt, and you'll see that it will generate a lovely information report for me. Okay, so you can see that Copilot has done a really nice job of putting that into an information report structure. And as I read through this, I can tell that the text level is going to be a little bit easier for my year sixes to comprehend than the text on the web page. So I could further refine and make changes to this, but I'm going to now export this to either Word or PDF. I'm going to open it and just check that the formatting is okay, and I can now get ready to use this passage in Reading Progress. So Reading Progress is one of our learning accelerators that you can use in Microsoft Teams. To set a Reading Progress assignment, I would head to Assignments here, and I head down and create a new assignment, but I need to pop into this Learning Accelerators menu and select Reading Progress. Now, I do have the opportunity when using Reading Progress to use a library, a sample library. I can actually use a button here to generate a reading passage, but it's fairly generic. I wanted something quite bespoke for the activity that I'm doing, so I've generated my content using Copilot CDP, and I'm going to import my generated passage into Reading Progress using this button. Now, I do have the opportunity to edit my text if I need to before I move on and set the task. There's a whole heap of settings that I can play with over the side here, but the most exciting one here is that I can add comprehension questions to this passage by flicking on this little toggle here and using Gen AI again, built into Microsoft Teams, to generate some questions based on the tree octopus text that I've imported. It's pretty cool, really. So I can generate however many questions that I'd like to. So let's select 5 here. And this is going to work away for me and create a self-marking quiz in Forms. So as a teacher, when I roll this out, I don't even have to mark the comprehension questions. So the workload reduction using these tools is absolutely astounding. And when I'm ready, I can actually hit the next button, give my reading task a title, and I'm just going to finish with a quick view of what the students would see when they access this task. So they would come in and they would click on their work. It would bring them out to an interface where they can record themselves reading. using video and audio. And when they press start, it will give them a countdown. And our learning accelerators are built into this interface, so they can play around with the settings here to make it easily decoded for them. When they're finished reading, it would take them to the next screen where they complete the comprehension questions, and then they would submit their assignment ready for me to have a look at how I can help them improve their reading. Okay, so once the student has obviously read and answered the questions, I'm just going to show you what it looks like for a teacher to be viewing the submitted response. This is just a demo that I have mocked up because for privacy reasons, I can't really have a student face there. But you can see here that once a student submitted, AI has actually analysed this passage. I repeated the when I was reading. I've mispronounced a couple of words here. They're coded in purple. I've got a couple of omissions as well. And as you go through here, you can see that it's continued to pick up on some of the mistakes that I'm making in my reading. I've actually had a 90% accuracy rate. So I can then use this data as a teacher to guide what I need my student to do to improve their reading progress. You can actually track ongoing insights through Microsoft Teams through the Insights tab if you're using these tools on a regular basis with your students as well. So Class Teams will actually keep track of all of the data from any of our learning accelerators, and we'll even give you things like assignment data and digital engagement data. So this data is going to be so powerful in really helping empower your students to achieve their best. If you'd like more tips and tricks on how to use Copilot for personalising learning or to learn more about our learning accelerators like Reading Progress, then head to Microsoft Learn Educator Centre and check out some of our on-demand courses. Thanks so much for listening.